Now I am going to explain about structure of pollen grain. This is the pollen grain. This pollen grain is formed from pollen mother cell by meiotic division, formation of microspores from microspore mother cell is called microsporogenesis. So whether this pollen grain is haploid or diploid, it is diploid, unicellular, uninucleate, haploid in nature. Pollen grain is unicellular, uninucleate, haploid in nature. As we are saying, haploid means number of genomes in pollen grain means one genome. Genome means one haploid set of chromosomes is called genome. Number of genomes in pollen grain, one. So the cell wall contains two layers, outer layer called exine, inner layer called entine. Exine is thick, entine is thin, exine is hard, entine is smooth. This exine is made up of sporopollenin. Exine is made up of sporopollenin, whereas entine is made up of pectocellulose. That means both pectin and cellulose, or cellulose and pectin, pectocellulose. Of these two layers, which one is a continuous layer and which one is a discontinuous layer? See, this layer exine comes here, coming, and here there is no exine. So again, from here it onwards. So here there is no exine, here there is no exine, here there is no exine. So which one is a discontinuous layer? Exine is a discontinuous layer. That means here sporopollen is absent. Sporopollen is absent. And that a pore, aperture, a hole is formed. That is so called germ pore. What is the function of germ pore? Through which pollen tubes are formed. Through which pollen tubes are formed. What is the role of germ pore? Means you have to say through which pollen tube is formed from entine. Which layer? Entine. That means that pollen tube is made up of pectocellulose. Pollen tube is made up of pectocellulose. So again, exine is thick. Exine is thick. Entine is thin. It is hard. It is smooth. Made up of sporopollenin. Entine is made up of pectocellulose. Exine is discontinuous layer, whereas entine is continuous layer. Germ pores are found in exine. Germ pores are found in exine. Germ pores are absent in entine. Germ pores absent means germ pores absent means sporopollen is present. Pollen grain, study of pollen grains is called palynology. Famous palynologist means Woodhouse, P.K.K. Nair, C.G.K. Ramanujam. Pollen grain is unicellular, that is single cell. Uninucleate, that is single nucleus present. Haploid in nature. Number of genomes in pollen grain or microspore is one. Number of wall layers. Wall means here cell wall. That means this pollen grain cell wall contains two layers, exine and entine. Generally, below the cell wall, cell membrane is present. It is understood matter. Number of wall layers means here cell wall layers. Number of wall layers in pollen grain means you have to say two, exine and entine. number of layers present outer to cytoplasm. That is outer to cytoplasm, what are the layers present? Cell membrane, intine, exine. So that is number of layers present around the cytoplasm means cell membrane, intine, exine. So how many layers? 3 layers. Very, very important. Next, what are the characteristic features of sporopollenin? So sporopollenin is the material found in exine of pollen grain. It is one of the most resistant organic material or inorganic material. It is one of the most resistant organic material, we have to say. It is not inorganic material. It is organic material. It can withstand high temperature. It can withstand strong acids. It can withstand strong alkalis also. So that it can withstand high temperature, strong acids and alkali. No enzyme can degrade the sporopollenin. That means enzymes cannot destroy the sporopollenin. Pollen grains are well preserved as fossils because of the presence of exine sporopollenin. Because of the presence of exine sporopollenin. I am asking some questions. Pollen grains are well preserved as fossils. Okay, it is true. Reason, what is the reason? Because of the presence of exine sporopollenin. True. Because of the presence of exine pectocellulose. False. Because of the presence of exine. True. Because of the presence of sporopollenin. True. Because of the presence of exine pectocellulose. False. Those points are, you have to remember. And next, when pollen grain, that is development of male gametophyte. So this pollen grain falls, that is transfer of pollen grains from anthers to the stigma is called pollination. Before that, pollen grain, first of all, it divides mitotically. Of course, though we are saying mitosis, that is chromosomes in mitosis, at metaphase, chromosomes are center of the cell. But first mitosis, asymmetric spindle apparatus form. That means chromosomes are not at center of the cell. So that's why two unequal cells are formed. Normally mitosis means two equal cells are formed. That is symmetric spindle apparatus formed. But this is the only condition in which asymmetric spindle apparatus formed. This is very, very important point. Asymmetric spindle apparatus are formed in which cell? Pollen grain. This asymmetric spindle apparatus occurs in the formation of, that means you have to say, both vestigial cell and generative cell. So first mitosis occur, that means two cells are formed. One is called vegetative cell, second one is called generative cell. So one is larger cell and another one is smaller cell. So this is called mitosis. Mitosis, that means first mitosis. And second mitosis also occur. This generative cell divides and form two male gametes. Two male gametes are formed from generative cell. What is the term generative cell? That means this cell is useful for further generations. That's why this name of the cell is so called generative cell. Mother cell of male gametes means, mother cell of male gametes means generative cell. So pollen grain develops into male gametophyte. This is partly developed male gametophyte. This is completely developed male gametophyte or mature male gametophyte. Number of cells in partly developed male gametophyte. This is one cell, this is one cell. Number of nuclei, this is one nucleus, this is one nucleus. Number of cells in partly developed male gametophyte. 2. Vegetative cell, generative cell. Number of nuclei in partly developed male gametophyte. 2. This one nucleus and this is another nucleus. This is the complete male gametophyte or mature male gametophyte or simply say male gametophyte. If the question is male gametophyte means we have to take mature male gametophyte only. Number of cells in mature male gametophyte means this is one vegetative cell and these are the two male gametes. Total 3 cells. Number of nuclei means 3. So I am asking some questions. Number of cells in partly developed male gametophyte 2. Number of nuclei in partly developed male gametophyte 2. Number of cells in mature male gametophyte 3. Number of nuclei in mature male gametophyte 3. So those points are written here. Number of cells in partly developed male gametophyte 2. What are those two cells? Vegetative cell, generative cell. Number of cells in mature male gametophyte 3. One vegetative cell and two male gametes. Number of nuclei in partly developed male gametophyte 2. Number of nuclei in mature male gametophyte 3. If the question is like this, number of cells and number of nuclei in male gametophyte, that means you have to take, question is just male gametophyte. If question is male gametophyte means you have to take mature male gametophyte only. Do not consider the partly developed male gametophyte. So one pollen grain develops into one male gametophyte. This is pollen grain. This entire thing is male gametophyte. These two are male gametes. These points are very, very important. Try to understand. This entire thing is called male gametophyte. These two are called male gametes. One male gametophyte contains how many male gametes? 2. One pollen grain produce how many male gametes? 2. One pollen grain produce male gametophytes means 1. Try to understand. I am going to explain once again. One pollen grain produces number of male gametes 2. One pollen grain produces number of male gametophytes. This whole thing is called male gametophyte. Mature male gametophyte. Whole thing is called male gametophyte. So one pollen grain produces one male gametophyte. One pollen grain produces two male gametes. Two important points are there. Asymmetric spindle occurs in which cell? Pollen grain. Asymmetric spindle occurs in the formation of, in the formation of means you have to say these cells, vegetative cell and generative cell. So what are the characteristics of vegetative cell and generative cell? This one is larger cell, this one is smaller cell. Here irregular shaped nucleus is present, normal nucleus is present. Here this cell is spindle shape. Here reserve food material is very much abundant reserve food material. Here generative cell rich cytoplasm, dense cytoplasm is present. What are the characteristics of vegetative cell and generative cell? Vegetative cell larger in size, generative cell smaller in size. Vegetative cell has abundant food reserve material, has abundant food reserve. Large irregularly shaped nucleus, large irregularly shaped nucleus. Large irregular shaped nucleus is found in which cell? Vegetative cell. Characteristics of generative cell, smaller in size. This generative cell contains dense cytoplasm, a rich cytoplasm. Which cell is spindle shape means this cell is spindle shape, generative cell is spindle shape. Which cell floats in the cytoplasm of vegetative cell? Generative cell. Generative cell is spindle shape and it floats in the cytoplasm of vegetative cell. And from this generative cell only, these two male gametes are formed by undergoing second mitosis. So that is, one pollen grain produces two male gametes by undergoing how many mitosis? Two mitosis. That is, number of male gametes formed, two. Number of mitosis required, two. Number of male gametes is equal to number of mitosis. Of those two mitosis, first one is a asymmetric spindle apparatus, second one is normal, that is symmetric. This is very very important. First mitosis belongs to asymmetric spindle, second mitosis is symmetric. So one pollen grain produces number of male gametes, two. One pollen grain produces number of male gametophytes, one. To produce two male gametes, number of mitotic divisions required, two. Of those two, one is asymmetric, second one is normal, symmetric. Number of mitosis is equal to number of male gametes. Suppose if the 500 male gametes are found, 500 male gametes are found, number of mitosis required, you have to say 500. How means? Number of male gametes is equal to number of mitosis. In that liberation means 60% of angiosperms. In 60% of angiosperms, pollen grains are liberated at this stage. Liberation means transfer of pollen grains from anther to the stigma is called pollination. In 60% of angiosperms, pollen grains are liberated yet. Pollen grains are shed at which cell stage? Two cell stage. That means at this stage, pollen grains are liberated and they fall on stigma. So in 60% of angiosperms, pollen grains are liberated yet. Pollen grains are shed at which cell stage? In 60% of angiosperms, pollen grains are shed at two cell stage. In remaining 40% of angiosperms, that means pollen grains are shed at three cell stage. What are those three cells? This is one vegetative cell and these two are two male gametes. These, at this stage, the pollen grains are liberated. So in majority of angiosperms, if the question is majority of angiosperms, pollen grains are shed at which stage, means of these two, majority of angiosperms means we have to take 60% of angiosperms. So that means majority of angiosperms are in 60% of angiosperms, pollen grains are shed yet two cell stage. So if you visit the opened anther and you touch that pollen grains, that yellowish powdery substance will be touched to your fingers, and take a glass slide and sprinkle those pollen grains on that slide with the help of a drop of water, and you may observe a variety of architecture. All the pollen grains are not in similar size, not in same shape, not in same design, not in same color. So the pollen grains sizes are different, shapes are different, colors are different, designs are different. All the pollen grains are not in similar in size, not in similar shape, not in similar shape, not in similar design. They may vary in different architecture in the structure of pollen grain. A group of pollen grains is called pollinia. Group of pollen grains is called pollinia. Try to read all these things and read the textbook carefully, line to line. That is very very important. Botany, we have to read line to line. Try to understand all these points. Try to understand all these points once again. And one point I am going to ask you. Polen tube is made up of means what we have to say. Polen tube is developed from which layer, exine or intine? That is from intine. Intine means pectocellulose. So that is Polen tube is made up of pectocellulose. It is developed from which cell? Wasted cell. Which layer? Intine. So Polen tube is developed from intine of wasted cell. Very very important. What is the function of Polen tube? Function of Polen tube means carrier of male gametes. So Polen tube is made up of means we have to say pectocellulose. Why we are saying pectocellulose? Polen tube is developed from, not from exine, it is developed from intine. From which cell? Vegetative cell. Intine of vegetative cell. Very very important point. Go through all these points once again, and thank you very much. I wish you all the very best.